Hi there, in today's video we are going to analyze the question that we posted on the community tab of the Parrot Climb YouTube channel, okay? We're gonna read through the question and we're gonna talk about them, okay? We made a question about the 8 of the wind that is reported by the tower, we made a question about regarding atmospheric stability, and then we made a question about true north, compass north and magnetic north. Alright, without further ado, let's jump right into it. Hi there, I'm Gabriele from ParrotClimb.com. I help you to become a better pilot. So if this is what you want to do, consider subscribing to the channel. And if you want to help me out, please give it a like to the video because this really helps. Alright, so without further ado, let's analyze the questions. Alright, so you can see we are here on the Parrot Climb YouTube channel. First of all, guys, at the moment of today, we've got 1,900 subscribers. So I'm very excited how the channel is growing. So thank you very much because you're making big, you're playing a big role in this, okay? So let's analyze the first question, okay? So the first question that we made 3 weeks ago was, what is the 8th of the surface wind reported by the tower during the takeoff and landing? So as you can see, we've got 106 volts, and the answer were very mixed because 38% answered 10 meters, 30% answered 15 meters, and 25% of you answered 5 meters, okay? The correct answer is 10 meters. So congratulations, because most of you, even though it was very mixed, but most of you answered correctly, okay? 10 meters is because the wind sensor that you got at the airport usually is a 10 meter height. So since the wind sensor is there, that's the wind that is actually reported to the tower, because the tower only reads the wind direction intensity from the sensor, and the sensor height is approximately 10 meters, okay? Beautiful. So now this is a picture that I personally took when I was going out of my place and I saw this atmosphere condition, okay? So the question was, is this atmosphere in the picture stable, unstable, or neutral? Okay, so many of you actually answered correctly. Okay, most of you answered that was actually a stable atmosphere. Let me explain you very quick. I'm gonna make a different video about that, but let me explain you what is a difference between a stable and unstable atmosphere. Okay, so the first thing that we need to understand when talking about stability and instability of the atmosphere is that we've got within the atmosphere, we've got this mass of air, okay? Every mass of air has got a different characteristics, okay? So you are in the open air, you're in the atmosphere, however, within the atmosphere, you have this mass of air. If the mass of air is warmer than the surrounding air, what will happen is that because it is warmer, it's lighter because it's less dense. And if it's less dense and lighter, what will happen is that this mass of air will start to rise, okay? So if the atmosphere is unstable, what will happen is that this mass of air is always lighter and less dense. Thus, you will never stop climbing, okay? Until it gets the condensation, then it becomes a cloud, and then it continues climbing. And you will see the typical cumulonimbus, for example. This is an indication that you've got an unstable atmosphere. However, in a stable environment, if the same mass of air starts to rise for any reason, okay, what will happen? It will rise. However, the mass of air will be colder and heavier. What will happen is that this mass of air suddenly will start to go down again and go back to its previous position, okay? So in this case, you have a stable atmosphere because this mass of air actually does this, okay? It climbs and then it stays there, okay? And if you force a lot of air to climb, okay, let's say you especially when you have a smoke, okay? If you have a smoke, the smoke is warm because it's coming from a fire, so it will climb. In a stable environment, you will see that the smoke will stay on the lower side of the atmosphere because it's not able to keep climbing, okay? So I hope this answered the second question. So the picture that I posted in the community tab the other day, it was a stable atmosphere in this example, okay? Because this air that you can see there was not able to climb, but it was actually on the low level and was spreading around like that, okay? Beautiful. So then, guys, I posted another community tab about the Parrot Climb website. I'm working very hard to make this website nice and with a lot of services that you can really use, okay? If you want to have a look, just have a look. If you have any feedback about the website, just leave a comment in one of my YouTube videos, because I'm reading all your comments, guys, okay? So then we've got the last questions that I made yesterday, one day ago, okay? So what will happen is that the wind direction reported on your meter takes as a reference the and then it's true north, magnetic north, and compass north. Many of you, the 61% of you, answered correct, is the true north. And the 38% is magnetic north. Okay, this is a very important point, because if your location, as you know, the magnetic variation is the angle between the true north and the magnetic north, all right? So if your magnetic variation is basically zero, because the magnetic variation changes, the angle between the true and the magnetic north changes depending from a place to a place, okay? And this is particularly important because your heading takes as a reference the magnetic north, and since your wind takes as a reference the true north, if the difference between the true and the magnetic north is big, you need to take this into account, okay? Because a crosswind can be a tailwind, for example, because if you're using a different reference, because you're on a plane, you're using the magnetic north, but the wind is using the true north, okay, you cannot really understand and calculate what's your headwind, tailwind, or crosswind wind component, okay? So, guys, thank you very much for asking. Thank you very much for taking your time. And if you have, guys, any questions about the topics that we just discussed, leave a comment below and I will help you out. Also, go to pilotclimb.com where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. I wish you a good day and I'll see you in the next one.